Welcome, everybody. I'm very happy to speak here at Pharma Circuit. I'm Marco van Damme. I'm CEO of TradesFinder. We're actually an Australian, Australian company. We started 2016. And as a CEO of TradesFinder, we're very happy to spread our wings. This morning I had a meetup with Canada and also now with a lot of German attendees. So very happy to meet you all. And afterwards, please feel free to interact with me personally. We can see where we can share knowledge and see if we can get together to grow and to help out in any way that we can. Our punchline from TradesFinder will definitely be businesses. Your business is defined by your people, because it's these days much more hard to engage with your people, even now with the 50-50 thing that we have here in the Netherlands, that 50% of the time everybody is working from home. And actually all of those COVID measures have been restricted further and further. So that's very hard for companies, I imagine, also in Germany and all over the globe. So for TradesFinder, our focus area is initially to streamline the hiring process. Not only streamline, it's optimizing, and it's by the way to obtain personality insights on your candidates. So have insights in your candidates before the first interview. This way, in improving the selection and engaging by the use of a chatbot, which enables you as a company to directly be in contact with your candidate. So somebody can find via your website or via your social that there is some position open. If you have very important, of course, is a good job description and it appeals to somebody, they can definitely direct via their phone or at their computer be in engagement with you as a company. And the great thing about that is as well that there is direct engagement back. So this will definitely be a huge plus. Even more so is the absence of human filters, because you have the ability to preset your queries. And this way reducing your bias in your selection. When you are able to select your winners by your preset algorithm, you definitely have a time and cost efficiency in this process. And you have something to give. And I'm really not saying that any system for that matter can make human contact of can replace that, because it's also very important still to have that gut feeling if somebody is really checking all the boxes of a candidate or a new employee that you like to have within your organization. But the ability to have a matching tool makes you has the ability to shortlist your candidate, and I think that is a huge plus as well. And that's where we have been focusing on in creating our solution. And I'd like to take you a little bit back in how this evolved and how we came about the company that we currently are. I mentioned this like the talk of life. Within TradesFinder, we are looking at linguistics. The way people talk, the way communication is actually founded many, many years ago in writing. 5000 VC, there were the initial clay tablets. The early methods of writing. And at that point, words and symbols were used by our ancestors long, long time ago. At that time, there was not even speech as much. And they just use these carvings for protection of sorcery and evil spirits and all that stuff. I find it very interesting where we come from. And then our brain adopted speech and it trained. And the beauty of this, is that globally it has changed in so many ways. Sounds, the way that it is being pronounced, even you have the clicking language in Africa, which is so completely different, and it's adopted by the use of that powerful thing in your head, your brain. The foundation and the academic background of TradesFinder is founded and based on the LIUC study. The LIWC stands for Linguistic Inquiry Word Count. This is actually initially by Penn Baker, a psychologist in the States, created. And there they took all the words and they make an index. And this has progressed by the use of AI, because this study created all these sorts of words and how people are using this to measure this towards the big five personality traits. And with that, a lot of different parts of the industry adapted this way, because they could get more information on how somebody is, looking inside the soft skills. And these days it is more more often the case that there are a lot of people having the same degrees, having worked in so-and-so job for so-and-so many times. And employers are now more focused on looking into the soft skills. You cannot change your personality, but you can study and gain knowledge. So our view is then also, diplomas is not what you are and not what you define. It's how you are. And starting 2016, we start developing and building our dream, and we combined the knowledge of the studies with the use of AI technology and some very bright developers that we attract to develop our chatbot Debra. We now have this chatbot in place with this combining knowledge, and we generate a dialogue, and that way we can create a personality profile that is for companies to work with and see how they how it matches their desires. So on this slide, I can only say words have power. As I said, the use of linguistics has a lot to do with the human brain. Not sure if also my cursor is visible, but I think it normally should be. There are different parts of the brain that are being signaled on different words and different sounds. And this way, we say, words have the ability to let people believe they can do more. They can do more than they actually can. Some of the verbs are actually signaling different parts of the brain than nouns. And this is very interesting. In 2007, there even was a cognitive study to see if they can put this thing and turn it around, if they can measure brain activity and by that can come up with the words. And this eventually is not far progressed, should enable a person who are actually not able to speak to via computer generate the words and make themselves heard. Very interesting stuff as well. So linguistics and the analyzers that we do, it's not a marble track. A lot of chatbots currently in the market today are, as I like to call it, a marble track. Like they have the questions, there are answers, and these answers are being checked. And if it is a yes or a no, you drop down in a certain bucket, and this is your personality outcome. It can be red, you can be yellow, you can be brown, you can be blue. All that sort of stuff is not the way that we have built our chatbot. Our linguistic analysis provide the chat transcript, and we analyze this up to the Luke and word indexes. And that way we get and generate these profiles. And for all we care, you as a company can put in every question, and a candidate can talk about how much he likes his goldfish. We do not care about the answers, and answers are not generating any outcomes. So I think that is very strong. And if there's any questions around that, I will check the chat later on, and I'm very happy to be in direct contact with you all. But doing it in this way, a company can self-create an algorithm, and this self-creating algorithm will support your selection. So it is very customized, and that way our clients can ask the questions that they want. And this also reduced time in the interview, because a lot of people and HR personnel that do a lot of interviews on a yearly basis say, well, the first 15 to 20 minutes, it's all the same questions. First 5 minutes from, oh, how was the traffic? Maybe that's a Dutch thing. Later on, it's what have you done, and where are you coming from? What's your experience and hobbies? And hobbies also, again, then you are entering a path of personal bias. And if you have a self-created algorithm, these presets will prevent this from happening more than when you have this, when you don't have this in place. So hit on Luke already, and natural language processing, that is the addition or the enhancement on the Luke system. Nowadays, it is just not only my opinion, but it's just what I see in the market, and I'm really anxious to learn if it's also the case at your ends, that hard skills are getting less essential than traits, than how personality fits the team. I'd like to have more discussions with you guys around that as well. So we addressed this problem, and we have entered the IBM Watson Entrepreneurs Program, and we built this way the culture of engagement. I think many of you guys already know about the Big Five personality pillars. They give insight on how a personality is built. The great thing about Big Five is that it has an academic and a scientific basis. Excuse me, in the elbow. And they have a scientific basis. The best thing that we offer in addition to this is that we also report on the facets. So every pillar of the Big Five has a breakdown of 5 to 6 personality traits. These are giving you much more information than just having like a pie chart on Big Five percentages and name. This is Marco. The way that we work is that we have the ability to really dive into the personality traits, and that is also why we call Traits Finder. How it works. You can create software all you want. If you do not have the guidelines in place, it will not be used. So within our, this is an actionable screen snippet of the use interface of the software, in which we have in place an academy, how you get started, movie clips also explaining where we come from, and how you can make your selection process a success. You can do branding, all sorts of things. It's a bit too salesy, so I'm gonna skip this one. The metrics. If you are, as a company, using our chatbot technology, seeing here on the right hand side, this is all completely customizable for the needs of our client, with the logo as well as the personality outcomes. And what we initially do is eliminating the standard forms. And it is a hiring process with already an assessment in place. Normally, it takes a lot of time to really get somebody on board. So an onboarding process can take a long time. And then in a lot of cases, there's also an assessment in place. And with this, we popularly said flatten the curve. I think that's a very 2020 buzzword. So yeah, getting answers on the basic questions that a normal recruiter would ask will add value to your recruitment process. Well, is being found. It has scientific research as a basis. And in all short, you know your candidate before you meet them. Seeing how you can shortlist it on the left-hand side. Desired match, your initial requirements that you can set, because of course we measure hard skills too, and you can pipeline your candidates towards an interview, phone call, any sort of connectivity you would like to have with them is in place. So here a little chart on how it's connected. All of you hopefully know already a bit on the Big Five and how it works. And on the right hand side, you see the actual facets that I talked about. So here you see openness, open to new experiences, has different facets that are correlated towards openness. And it is imagination and intellect. And you can see of everybody, even if your candidate or for internal use, you can see the outcomes per facet, per a Big Five pillar, and we report this. In addition, and I said a little bit already on looking inside your organization, we can use this same technology for an engagement survey. Also with the facets reporting, but if you're looking inside your own organization, you have the ability to hook this up to Slack, to any sort of communication method that you're using within your organization, and you can measure over a longer period of time the sentiments of your teams. And even now in times that there is so much home office, engagement is very important to think on as an employer. This engagement tool is completely anonymized. It is, you can look into your own team and you can just see the cultures and the sentiments of an individual over a longer period of time. This is a different product than the recruitment chatbot, but I definitely want to see this because we are making really progress on building this, and it has a lot of advantages also for pharma branch. So this is the part of the presentation that I would like to end with. And I definitely hope that we could make it some sort of interaction. So I'm not sure if I'm able to see any of your questions somewhere. So you took it back, Mario.
Thank you very much.